now on WRDE Coast TV.
Growth, but at what cost? Cape Henlopen needs more room, but the land isn't cheap and the price tag, it's divisive.
A fall-like air mass will be taking over for the next few days here along the coast. I'll break down how Idalia is the culprit behind this cooler weather coming up in just a few moments.
Multiple roadwork projects on the way. What projects DelDOT has in store now that the summertime is over.
Rehoboth Parking topping conversation once again. What issues specifically with spots is coming up.
And teacher shortage, staff to Indian River School District running out of time to fill vacancies, what they will do if they come up short.
From the beaches to the bay, coverage you can count on. WRDE Coast TV, your local news at 11 starts right now.
Getting ready for off-season construction to begin. Good evening, I'm Charlie Sakaitis.
And I'm Mallory Metzner. Welcome to our News at 11. We begin tonight with two roadwork projects.
New at 11, DelDOT is preparing to start projects that couldn't be done during summer's heavy traffic.
Coast TV News reporter Charles Reinert is in the newsroom. Charles, DelDOT is asking drivers for patience.
Charlie and Mallory, two roadwork projects are ready to break ground as the curtain on the summertime starts to come to a close, and they will slow down your commute.
More orange barrels are on the way to Delaware Roads. DelDOT is scheduled to begin construction on Route 1 right outside of Rehoboth Mall on September 5th. DelDOT CR McLeod says this roadwork needs to be done at the right time.
The summertime is really the best time to be doing construction. Obviously, with the influx of visitors that we have into Sussex County each summer, that makes that a challenge. So we really have to juggle these timelines.
The construction outside Rehoboth Mall will chop Coastal Highway from three lanes to two as DelDOT widens the southbound turning lane into the mall. It's expected to take about 2 months to complete.
The Route 1 construction isn't the only roadwork project DelDOT has planned now that summertime has come to a close. Behind me here at Robinsonville Road, DelDOT will be shutting things down for about a month to continue construction here at Five Points.
The construction at Robinsonville Road will realign lanes into Plantation Road. That project begins September 11th. This is in preparation for the upcoming roundabout nearby. Mike Maybaum says, though it will be a hassle, he's excited to see the final product.
We're about 25 years behind in infrastructure right now in our local community. So it's going to be an inconvenience to everybody, including myself. But in the long run, it'll be better for everybody.
As the sun goes down on another summer, the tourists are heading out and the work trucks are coming in.
There is one more major roadway project that is scheduled to begin a little bit further down the road in October. Plantation Road will be closed between Shady Road and the Lowe's on Route 1, and that's expected to be in effect for 6 months. Back to you at the desk.
Thank you, Charles. New at 11, DENREC has issued a temporary emergency variance for air quality to Purdue Foods' Milford processing plant. The agency says plant managers discovered a critical failure in one of their permitted boilers on Sunday. The DENREC Division of Air Quality says a temporary air permit will allow for the construction and operation of a rental boiler. The agency says a rental boiler is allowed to operate for 90 days. The variance also requires Purdue to develop a boiler maintenance plan in Milford. Let's take a live look outside into our Hershey Exteriors camera at the 45th Street Tap House there in Ocean City. Another warm summer night here along the coast. And our first alert, meteorologist Alex Seymour is in for Paul Williams tonight, joining us now with a look at our forecast. Good evening, Alex.
Good evening, Mallory and Charlie. We've got some gorgeous conditions out the door this evening. Temperature-wise, we are starting to see those clouds starting to filter into the region, though. As we take a live look out on our Boardwalk Plaza Hotel camera in Rehoboth Beach, pretty quiet evening there in Rehoboth Beach. Not a whole lot of activity going on the boardwalk temps, though. Still sitting at about 76 degrees. That's really the warmest it's going to be for the next several days, as we're going to start to see some cooler fall-like air start to move into the area. Right now, though, we're in the 70s all across the region. Warmest temps right at the immediate coastline, so 77 in Bethany Beach, 76 in Rehoboth Beach, and 75 degrees in Lewis. The wind's still pretty light right now, still coming out of the north, but they're going to be turning more easterly as the remnants of Hurricane Idalia start to work its way up towards the region. That's going to pick up our winds out of the east, bringing some clouds, but also bringing some cooler air. So tomorrow, our UV index forecast brought to you by Face of Grace Practice and Sun Safety, a UV index of 5.
Thank you, Alex. If it feels you've heard about more weather disasters in recent years, that's because you have. The federal government keeps track of disasters that cost at least $1 billion.
In the 80s, there were about 3 a year. Last year, there were 18. As Emily Schmidt reports, President Biden has weighed in on the causes and the true cost.
As difficult as it is to watch water churn, waves invade, landscapes shift in seconds.
Look, there it goes. There it goes.
It takes longer to see the big picture cost of storms like Idalia.
It's far too early to even estimate what the cost is.
The Federal Emergency Management Agency administrator says there are 1,500 federal responders on the ground, including 300 from FEMA. Criswell is expected to tour Florida Thursday, as she toured Hawaii last week after the wildfires.
I don't think anybody can deny the impact of the climate crisis anymore.
The costs add up. Wednesday, President Joe Biden announced $95 million for Hawaii's electrical grid, $400 million to remove debris. Even before Maui and Florida, the federal government says 15 events this year cost more than $39 billion. FEMA's director says the Emergency Management Relief Fund could run dry without more money from Congress.
We are looking at what the cost of these storms are as we approach the end of this fiscal year.
President Biden says there should be no debate.
How can we not respond? My God, how can we not respond to these needs? And so I'm confident, even though there's a lot of talk from some of our friends up on the Hill about the cost, we got to do it.
Budget talks loom, as does the rest of hurricane season. I'm Emily Schmidt reporting.
While Idalia is no longer a hurricane, the storm did continue to wreak havoc along the pathway. Look at the video here. You can see this storm lashing in South Carolina on a highway before a car is flipped into the air. Officials with the Goose Creek Police Department say two people did suffer minor injuries in that crash. Just incredible video there. New at 11, Governor John Carney has ordered the Delaware flag to be flown at half staff tomorrow. That will be to recognize International Overdose Awareness Day. This applies to all state facilities from sunrise to sunset, but the governor says local governments, businesses, and all Delawareans can also raise awareness for both overdose prevention and all who've lost a loved one due to overdose.
The Cape and Lopen School District has been clear it needs more space. Now it's selected a large parcel of land it wants to buy at the cost of $15.5 million. 40% of this would be paid for by taxpayers and the rest by the state. The district chose this property because it's about where DLDOT road improvements will take place anyway. This would allow more flexibility in creating access points to the new district office, but not everyone agrees the price is justifiable.
The expansion that they're talking about seems very big, and I'm just not sure if the size of the school district and administration would warrant such a huge budget and a huge expansion.
The district does need to submit their certificate of necessity by tomorrow, and they expect to hear back about that certificate by November. At that point, the district will decide where they would like to go next with their plans.
This brings us to our Coast TV poll. We want to know, what do you think about Cape Henlopen's district proposal for the land purchase and all that expansion? Let's look at the results.
Take a look at the screen here. It looks like 10% think it's a great idea. The majority, 61%, say it's too expensive. 27% of people who voted in our poll think that a new school needs to be built instead. And 2% thinks they need to choose a different location.
Now, if you haven't voted yet, you still can. This has changed a bunch today. Go to WRDE.com or use our mobile app. And the Indian River School District says it has about 33 job openings, and the clock is ticking to hire for all those positions. Even though the school district hopes to fill all their teacher positions by the beginning of the school year, they say they do have a plan in place in case they can't reach that goal.
We're going to have to use long-term substitutes in those classrooms. Obviously, that's not an optimal, situation because the kids will have a different teacher eventually, and that's not really a good situation.
Mall says getting retired teachers to substitute would help them if that's the solution. To learn about all those open positions and how you can apply, visit our website, WRDE.com.
New at 11, Delaware State Police says a man was found dead on a trail in Dover this morning. Troopers say it happened before 6:30 a.m. on the Isaac Branch Greenway Trail in the area of South Bay Road and President Drive. They say 63-year-old Mark Garrett of Dover was found dead with injuries from a blunt force. Police say they don't have any suspect information at this time and are still trying to figure out what Mr. Garrett was doing on the day before his death.
I'm Madeline Overturf. Here's a look at just some of the things happening across Delmarva. Prospective hunters in Dorchester County, a new program will teach you how to hunt for free. It's a mentorship program for those who don't know how to hunt deer, organized by the Fish and Wildlife Service. The mentees will go on a guided hunt in late October. According to the National Park Service, tourism at Assateague National Seashore generates $116 million to the local economy. That's through hotel bookings, restaurants, and more. That spending supported 1,410 jobs as well. Parking in Rehoboth Beach once again dominating discussion. In a special meeting scheduled for Tuesday, commissioners will hear a presentation on the minimum number of parking spaces required for certain uses. You may recall parking requirements for hotels was a divisive issue earlier this year. That's a look at just some of the things happening across Delmarva. I'm Madeline Overturf.
Sussex Tech in Georgetown is increasing the school security team for this school year. The team is headed up by a lead constable who is also a coordinator of school safety. The school safety team now includes multiple school resource officers, school climate officers, and multiple constables. Additionally, Sussex Tech faculty and staff members have been trained in the standard response protocol and standard reunification methods in the case of a traumatic event at the school.
It was another scary moment for Mitch McConnell today as the Senate minority leader appeared to freeze for a second time during a press conference. The episode happened in Kentucky, the senator's home state, during a press conference. When asked about running for re-election, McConnell froze up, not speaking for over 30 seconds. And that included when an aide tried to assist him, repeating the question to the senator. Once McConnell regained his abilities, he responded briefly to another question before being escorted away. Senator McConnell previously froze during a press conference on Capitol Hill in July. We are just getting started here this evening.
Coming up, oyster priorities, the meeting Senator Carper will be at tomorrow to determine what needs to go into a farm bill.
Wade Dalio will bring Delmarva some rough surf over the coming days, but precipitation-wise, we're looking bone dry. I'll let you know if any rain is in the forecast, coming up just after the break.
Next, Pumpkin Chunkin'. It's been a long time since Delaware has seen a good gourd launched through the air, where the World Championships will be this year. We'll be back in just 60 seconds.
Delmarva customers choose Coastal Bath.
Coastal Bath works with you. We were able to get everything we wanted at the price we wanted. We just loved working with them.
Coastal Bath gave us a beautiful walk-in shower. It's much safer.
Coastal Bath is the number one choice for us.
Now extended. Coastal Bath's sizzling summer savings is hot. Take $2,500 off your new bathroom now through August 31st. Listen to Logan. Local and family owned. Call or visit CoastalBaths.com to schedule a free in-home estimate today.
Hi, I'm Joel Wharton, Sussex County farmer. Don't wait until after harvest to plant your cover crops. Consider broadcasting or interseeding cover crops into your standing cash crop. Early establishment provides more growth potential and more soil armor over winter. It also saves time because after harvest, the cover crop is already growing and protecting the soil, cycling nutrients, and preventing erosion. To learn more about the benefits and ways to establish cover crops early, contact the Sussex Conservation District because every acre can.
In less than 2 months, the World Championship Pumpkin Chunkin' will be held in Oklahoma. You can see some past video we shot here at the Pumpkin Chunkin'. The Sussex County Classic started in 1986 and for nearly its entire run was held in the Bridgeville area. People enjoying chucking pumpkins with homemade machines to compete for an ultimate prize. Pumpkin Chunkin' has not been held in Delaware for years. Organizers said they did not have adequate space on Delmarva, and a lawsuit halted competition after a woman was critically injured. The lawsuit was later dismissed. This year, Pumpkin Chunkin' will be held at a tractor store off Route 66 in Oklahoma on October 28th at 10 a.m.
Happening tomorrow, a roundtable discussion on oyster aquaculture is going to be held at the University of Delaware Lewis campus. The senator, U.S. Senator Tom Carper, scheduled to be in attendance. His office says he's going to join oyster farmers to talk about their priorities for oyster aquaculture in the upcoming farm bill.
Roads and beaches will be busy over Labor Day weekend, and Rehoboth Beach Patrol is reminding beachgoers to be careful in the water and look out for rip currents. The patrol says rip currents appear as brownish, murky water that looks different than the water around it. You may also see a straight, funnel-like line out to sea from the beach. If caught in a rip current, lifeguards say to stay calm, don't panic, face the shore and swim parallel to the beach. Then swim in once you stop feeling the current pulling on you. If you aren't sure that swimming is a good idea, lifeguards want you to know that they're there to help.
If you're not super confident in your swimming abilities, come talk to us. Find us, whether we're on the beach, at the headquarters here on Baltimore Avenue, or we're on our chair. You want to touch base with the lifeguard, have them explain the conditions to you, and then figure out what's going to be the best course of action for you to enjoy your beach day, but to also be safe at the same time.
And Beach Patrol does expect that rip currents could be present over the upcoming Labor Day weekend.
Yeah, those rip currents certainly looking like they're going to be an issue, at least for the next few days here along our coast as we continue to deal with the impacts from some tropical systems that are moving through the Atlantic and moving through the southeast United States. That's Franklin, Hurricane Franklin, that's been dealing, causing all kinds of issues at our beaches the last few days. And now Idalia, which is working its way up towards the mid-Atlantic. So that rip current danger, that is going to remain a high risk through Saturday. So if you do plan on going to the beach, make sure you're swimming near a lifeguard, or maybe just stay out of the water really until Saturday. Conditions will start to improve during the second half of the holiday weekend. And Idalia is not only bringing those dangerous rip currents, also going to bring a bit of fall air. So it's probably not even going to be warm enough to hop in the water. Temps are going to be falling down into the 70s, even the upper 60s on parts of Delmarva for those afternoon highs. And along with it, we're going to be dealing with some pretty gusty winds on Thursday. So tomorrow, we're expecting winds gusting 30 to 40 miles per hour at the immediate coastline. That summer-like heat, though, that is going to return for this second half of the Labor Day holiday weekend. We're talking about temps climbing up into the mid-90s by Labor Day Monday. Right now, as we take a live look out on our Gateway Subaru camera at the Commander Hotel, a few people still out there on the boardwalk this evening, but overall, pretty quiet evening in Ocean City. Temps sitting right around 76 degrees at this hour. We're in the 70s all across Delmarva. This is kind of right around where those temps will be throughout the daytime hours tomorrow. Probably a little bit warmer than they actually will be tomorrow afternoon right at the beaches, where we're currently sitting at 76 in Bethany Beach and 76 in Rehoboth Beach. We're likely going to stay in the low 70s at the beaches tomorrow, maybe even the upper 60s. Winds right now coming out of the north, they're going to be turning to more out of the east over the next few hours as these clouds continue to thicken up and Idalia continues to work its way up the coast. Right now, it's moving through South Carolina as a tropical storm. It's going to move through North Carolina and then eventually zip out into the Atlantic. But as it gets closer, those easterly winds pick up, and we're going to be dealing with that for the next couple of days. Also, this cold front, good thing that's there. Otherwise, we would be dealing with all the impacts of Idalia other than just some clouds and some gusty winds. Overall, here we go on our future cast. We're going to see the clouds really sticking around throughout the overnight hours into Thursday morning. But the good news is, take a look at this. As we head throughout the next couple of days, our UV index forecast brought to you by Face of Grace Practices Sun Safety. Tomorrow's really the only day with those clouds. We're back up to a UV index of 8 by Saturday, and then really the rest of the Labor Day weekend looks wonderful. Our Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling 7-day forecast shows temps going from the 70s next couple of days into the 90s early next week.
Still to come, happy in new homes. These dogs went through a lot, but finally, after dangerous neglect, they've now been adopted into new safe families.
And next, stop traffic, how your input could keep things moving in Rehoboth Beach.
The Car Store's Labor Day Sale, going on now through Saturday. Save big with best in market pricing. Get more for your trade. Plus, enjoy the added protection and value of the Car Store's Certified Advantage. Don't miss the Car Store's Labor Day Sale, going on now. TheCarStoreOnline.com.
Coastal Delmarva has so much going on.
Food, friends, fun, and more.
Why don't we just show you?
Coastline, weekdays at 4 on Coast TV.
Smart shades set the vibe. Protection from the sun. Party vibes. Relaxed in bed. Cozy vibes. Lower energy bills. Energy savings vibes. Smart shades do the work for you, making it easier to create the right vibe. Book your free consultation today at budgetblinds.com.
The new upscale OC Chopsticks Asian Bistro is the place to go for fresh, hand-selected ingredients used to create the most delicious Asian delicacies. Come dine in, have a drink, and let our skilled chefs prepare your authentic Thai, Chinese, and Japanese dishes. At OC Chopsticks, we take what was good and make it better. Sushi rolls, noodle soups, General Tso's chicken, you see where we're going. Anything made fresh is better. Serving lunch and dinner daily, located at the Ocean City Outlets. OC Chopsticks Asian Bistro. We stay fresh.
She has 3 Grammys, 16 ACM Awards, 7 CMAs, 14 AMAs, and the Kennedy Center Honors.
But there's still one left.
Reba McEntire joins The Voice this fall on NBC.
Not yet, Reba.
Sorry.
The Car Store's Labor Day Sale, going on now through Saturday. Save big with best in market pricing. Get more for your trade. Plus, enjoy the added protection and value of the Car Store's Certified Advantage. Don't miss the Car Store's Labor Day Sale, going on now. TheCarStoreOnline.com.
New at 11, the city of Rehoboth Beach wants your input on traffic and parking in the busy beach town. The city rolled out its new website, Reach Out Rehoboth, last week. There are several projects online for how the public can weigh in. The study to identify solutions to traffic and parking is asking for your input on things like parking demand, bicycles and pedestrian facilities, speed reductions, and more.
Today, families waited to bring home a new member of their family at the Brandywine Valley SPCA Animal Rescue Center. The dogs were rescued from a disgusting SUV.
Coast TV News reporter Alyssa Weber takes us to the adoption day, where a new leash on life is just beginning.
Dogs being carried home to get a second chance at life. That was the scene at the Brandywine Valley SPCA Animal Rescue Center in Georgetown. Just a few days ago, these 14 dogs, 12 of whom are up for adoption Wednesday, were living a life of cruelty in a filthy SUV in Lewis. David McHenry and his wife were one of the many families eager to give one of the dogs a new home.
They've had a rough life. It's time for them to enjoy. We've rescued dogs before and just feels so good.
These 12 dogs are finding the perfect home for them thanks to this animal rescue questionnaire. Despite the dog's sad past, found in feces and debris in a car, and others found a disgusting home, the Brandywine Valley SPCA says the dogs are ready for a new home. And all the owners filled out forms with details ensuring the dogs never go back to conditions like these.
We're going to give him the promise of a brand new life, a loving home. You know, this is what he needs. He's not had the greatest life till now, and it's time for him to have a loving family.
Claire Columna couldn't wait to take her newly adopted pup home.
She's getting a bath. After that, we're going to find him a bed and introduce him to the grandson.
After the pain these dogs have been put through, a new life of love helping to heal. The Animal Rescue Center. I'm Lisa Weber, Coast TV News.
Flight attendants at American Airlines have voted to strike. They're fighting for a new contract with pay raises and more staffing on flights. It's a good time to ask for it. Just last week, the airline reached a deal with pilots that gives them a 21% raise and a 46% raise by 2027. American also posted a $1.3 billion profit last quarter on the back of strong ticket sales and a decline in the price of jet fuel.
Former Donald Trump attorney Rudy Giuliani has lost the defamation suit brought against him by Georgia election workers. A federal judge ruled Giuliani forfeited the lawsuit filed by election workers Ruby Freeman and Shay Moss. Giuliani signaled out Freeman and Moss when he made false claims of ballot tampering in Georgia after the 2020 election. The mother and daughter say that they suffered emotional and reputational harm and their safety was put in danger. They're asking for unspecified damages, which could amount to thousands or even millions of dollars. There will be a trial later this year or early next year that will determine the amount of those damages. Coming up in sports, the Phillies back on the diamond today, trying to sweep the Angels back to LA. Our Delmarva Sports Network crew has the highlights. And coming up next, a warning, do not drink and drive, what Maryland police are doing over the holiday weekend to keep everybody safe from impaired drivers.
Fleischer Brothers and Coast TV are honoring military persons and first responders serving Delmarva.
We salute Chief Derek Harvey of the Milton Police Department. With over 25 years of experience, Chief Harvey stands as a beacon of unwavering integrity, leadership, and commitment. Notably in Milton, he ascended from lieutenant to captain in 2019 and has served as both a K-9 officer and acting chief. His dedication extends beyond the police, having been an influential figure in the Milton Volunteer Fire Department since 1998, rising to the rank of fire chief in 2018.
If you have a family member, friend, or community member that you would like to nominate for a Coast TV salute, go to CoastTVSalutes.com.
We just bought our first home. Sure, there's a lot to fix and money's tight, but thanks to my husband, we're keeping our spirits high and all our costs low. Cause with him, the glass is always half full.
Babe, got it.
Even if it's leaking.
You're always there for them.
Of course.
And we're always here for you. Food Lion, here for every moment.
Thinking about upgrading your bath or shower? Bath by Spicer Brothers is making it easy with a limited time offer.
Right now, receive $1,000 off your new shower or bath. Save 50% off installation, plus 0% financing with no payments until 2025.
Choose your favorite style and color, and it can be installed in as little as one day.
Have peace of mind with our Platinum Plus lifetime warranty and factory certified 5-star installation guaranteed.
So before you sign, keep Bath by Spicer Brothers in mind.
America, it's time to gear up and get out there in a new Ford vehicle. And it all starts at your local Ford dealer during the Discover Summer Sales Event. Choose from a great selection of trucks and SUVs equipped with the tech and comfort you need to discover your best summer ever. With a large inventory in stock, now is the best time to trade in, trade up, and discover summer with Ford. Get 2.9% for 60 months plus $1,000 bonus cash on Ford F-150. But hurry, offer ends August 31st.
It's always a good time to protect and improve your home's value. At Pinnacle Concrete Coatings, our highly trained experts are dedicated to creating beautiful, durable floors at a fair, honest price. And most jobs are completed in just one day. Our multi-step process uses heavy-duty, high-precision equipment to create gorgeous floors that stand the test of time. 4 times stronger than epoxy and resistant to abrasions, chemicals, and UV damage. And all residential applications are backed by a lifetime warranty. Call to schedule your free estimate. Pinnacle Concrete Coatings, because quality matters.
The most incredible shopping on the beach, Lume Boutique. Fashion, jewelry, and accessories as cool as an ocean breeze. You'll love this place. We put a smile on your face. You'll love this place. It's Lume Boutique. Fashion, jewelry, accessories, and fun. Lume Boutique.
4 convenient locations, 2 in downtown Lewis, Milford, and Longneck, and easy online shopping at bloomingboutique.com.
Maryland State Police want to get ahead of potential aggressive drivers on the road during Labor Day weekend. Police say troopers from all 23 barracks will conduct heavy patrols throughout the weekend. This is part of the No DUI Friday National Highway Traffic Safety Administration initiative. Locally, the Salisbury Barrack will focus its efforts on Routes 50 and 13.
The Delmarva Sports Network from the Wawa Studios.
The Phillies hosted the Angels for the final game of a 3-game series today. The Phillies looking for the sweep, and the Angels looking to snag a win before they heading back to California. Former Phillies first overall pick Mickey Moniak receiving his NL championship ring pregame from Dave Dombrowski. But on the field, top second runner on for Hunter Renfroe, and he bashes one to deep left. That ball leaves in a hurry. Angels take an early 2-0 lead. Top three now, game tied at 2. Shohei Ohtani at the dish, chops one to first, and Bryce Harper makes an impressive snag and turn for the double play. Take another look. This ball was destined for the deep right field corner, but Bryce flashing some leather at his new position to end the inning. But defense isn't where the Phillies made their mark today. Bottom six, Angels back up 2. Trey Turner puts a charge into that baseball to blow the roof off the bank. Make that 58 homers for the Phillies in August, the most ever by an NL team. Then bottom eight, Phillies down 1. Harper at the plate, and Mr. Clutch sends a moonshot to deep right center field into the seats. Big for the team, but also big for the individual. That's his 300th career blast. The Angels still had some fight in the final inning. The Halos already tied it against Craig Kimbrell, and Brandon Drury unties it. A two-run opposite field home run to go ahead for good. The Angels win it 10-8. The loss ends the Phillies' five-game winning streak. They'll be back in action on Friday night in Milwaukee. That'll do it for sports.
Time to get one last look at our Coast TV poll. We want to know, what do you think about Cape Henlopen School District's proposed land purchase and expansion? Let's look at the results. They've been moving around all night, but too expensive is the leader. 62% build a new school, coming in a distant second at 25%. You can still vote on WRDE.com. We'll be right back.
Delmarva's hit music station, 102.5 WBOC.
So here's my back to school haul. Backpack from Cali, kicks from Lou's, accessories by me, and new fast internet from Extreme. Our basic internet was not going to cut it. See you in class.
Go back to school with best in fast internet and Wi-Fi from Extreme. Save on speeds from 100 meg up to 1 gig, including whole home Wi-Fi with advanced online security and parental controls. Packages start at $24.99 a month for a year. Call 844-EXTREME-2 for details.
Step 1. Join Club Ocean at Ocean Downs. Step 2. Get $20 free play guaranteed. Step 3. Play, celebrate, and join an ocean of winners like these. Ocean Downs Casino, where the fun shines.
Come check out the newly expanded mattress lineup at Johnny Janosik, your one-stop mattress superstore. Shop now and save up to $600 on select adjustable bases with your mattress purchase of $19.99 or more. And we have the best bed-in-a-box brands starting at just $6.99. Take your mattress home and sleep on it tonight. And rest easy with 0% APR financing for 60 months. Shop the Labor Day mattress sale at your one-stop mattress superstore, Johnny Janosik's Mattress World.
BMW iX is electricity in its ultimate form. An elegant trailblazer that's equal parts power and intelligence. With impeccable interior details, range of up to 324 miles, and a panoramic moonroof for every shade of luxury. It's 100% electric and 100% BMW. BMW, the ultimate electric driving machine.
Go electric, go BMW at IG Burton BMW in Melford.
The new upscale OC Chopsticks Asian Bistro is the place to go for fresh, hand-selected ingredients used to create the most delicious Asian delicacies. Come dine in, have a drink, and let our skilled chefs prepare your authentic Thai, Chinese, and Japanese dishes. At OC Chopsticks, we take what was good and make it better. Sushi rolls, noodle soups, General Tso's chicken, you see where we're going. Anything made fresh is better. Serving lunch and dinner daily, located at the Ocean City Outlets. OC Chopsticks Asian Bistro. We stay fresh.
Wheel of Fortune, celebrating 41 years of excitement.
A brand new season with all new episodes starting in September.
Finally tonight, new at 11, drumroll please, Delaware waterfowl and trout stamp art winners have been chosen. Take a look at these beauties. A 10-time winner and first-time winner both represented this year. Jeffrey Kleinfelter, a well-known artist in the state, painted the redhead duck here. And first-time winner Trevor Dumas from Colorado painted the rainbow trout. Incredible work by both men. They each win $2,500 in cash and 150 artist proofs of the work.
We've got some fall-like weather on the way for the next couple of days, but we should stay dry as Idalia remains just off to our south, so probably won't need an umbrella, but rain will eventually return. Probably not the next 10 days, but it will eventually return. Coast TV umbrella giveaway winner this evening, John Gritman from Lewis, Delaware. Congratulations. So here we go for our Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling 10-day forecast. We're dry through Labor Day weekend. Temps going from the mid-70s tomorrow, low to mid-70s tomorrow, into the mid-90s by Labor Day Monday. And then next week looks pretty hot for the first full week of September. We're talking about highs in the 90s Monday all the way through next Friday.
Thank you, Alex, and thank you for joining us for Coast TV News at 11. For more news and local weather, download our Coast TV News app.
The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon is up next. We'll see you tomorrow for Coast TV News at 5 a.m. Have a great night.